Okay, we're here at Myeongdong. As you can see, there are lots of street food here and a lot of vendors and lots of shops and lots of people. This is like their most commercial street, and you'll see the different kinds of street food, from seafood, from dumplings, dim sum, and dessert and fruits. There's also lobster. You'll see there's a lot of lobsters here, just like Japan. If you've been to Osaka, this is like Dotonburi. Or if you've been to Taiwan, this is very similar to the Ximending Street. So yeah, it's like a very commercialized area with vendors and shops and food. So this is Myeongdong.
Here you'll find many of Korea's popular food, like the tteokbokki, dumplings, Korean pancake, gimbap, fish cake, bulgogi, and many, many more. There are definitely no shortage of choices here. The feeling you get is like eating in a turo-turo in the Philippines, only a lot cleaner and a little less smellier. But be warned, because the people here can get a bit rude. I remember I was pushed away by an old lady. We were asked to leave. And I also had an argument with one of the stall owners because she didn't want me to take pictures of her store. But all in all, I found Koreans to be very nice and polite. It was just here in Gwangjang Market where I actually encountered these people. Here in Gwangjang, you will also see a lot of very exotic food. You can even help yourself with a serving of raw octopus with all their tentacles still moving while swallowing them. Nice, right? As you can see, she just took out one of them from an aquarium, started slicing it, removing its organs, and chopping it till they're bite-sized. Yummy. Also here in Gwangjang Market, you will find what the Koreans call gaibul, or popularly known as the penis fish. Gai, or gae, meaning dog, and bull, meaning male gonads. But a gonad is actually a reproductive organ, like a testicle or something. It's usually around 10 to 30 centimeters long, brownish yellow in color, and kind of looks like the sex organ of a dog.
Look at her, she's in her handbook.
Do you want to make sure?
Okay, so we are on our way to the Gyeongbukgong Palace.
Okay, so the Gyeongbukgong Palace is right over there. So where are we?
Palace.
Palace. Gyeongbukgong.
My costume is a mama, queen, and then my hubby's costume is Heya, king of Joseon dynasty.
It's hot, huh? But it's windy.
There's our tour group over there.
And here is our, wala na?
Here is our,
umma, mother, umma, umaga ya.
Umaga.
Okay. Umaga.
With the marching band.
We're gonna watch now the changing of guards. Here, they're gonna come from there. And then they're gonna march here. Our tour guide said this is the best spot to watch them. So nice because I really feel like I'm in Joseon dynasty. So my costume is the queen of Joseon dynasty. Mama, queen, mama.
Okay.
And my husband's costume.
Si Carlo Pimbo.
And my husband's costume is Peya. As you can see, Peya means king.
Peya means you pay.
Also, the graduate ceremony will take place at 10 o'clock. You chose a dynasty. The security of the palace and the capital city was related to the safety of the royal family. This is a very history of the
how are you doing, babe?
Fish, right? And then she has to make beef.
Anchovy. It's a stuff run.
Miso soup.
Yeah, miso soup.
Right? Bibimbap, mixed with rice. This one is gochujang. This one is gochujang.
Gochujang.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Hi, we're here in Bukchon Village. And this alley is the where Grim Reaper and Sunny had their first kiss.
With the sound effects, huh?
This corner over here, that gate and this gate is also from Goblin. Here, those eight from here.
Hanoks are traditional Korean houses, which are made out of wood and clay. So this is one of the most preserved houses here. And they say nowadays that it is reserved for those who are major rich and upscale. So this is a high-end neighborhood. So while you guys are going around this village, you also have to keep quiet because there are a lot of people. Yeah.